It's very early in the morning, and here I am at Heathrow, Terminal 3, about to set off for Prague to go to the International Congress of Phonetic Sciences.
And if you've got to switch the signs back on at any point during the flight, if you can't return to your seat and fasten your belts, really appreciate your full attention on that. So I'll speak to you a little bit later on when we're closer to Prague with an update on the weather there.
Prague is famous for its cafe culture. Apparently both Kafka and Einstein were regulars here. The Czech for cafe is kavárna, and like almost all Czech words, it's stressed on the first syllable. So the acute accent indicates not stress, but vowel length, kavárna. This is Prague's famous old town square, one of these huge medieval town squares. This one is so beautiful, and there's really too much to see and do, especially when you've come on a short trip for phonetics.
You know, the traditional textbooks will tell you that has up to 6 trills, but it almost never does unless you are really, you know, emotional or stuff like that.
Does it usually have at least one?
It usually has one.
So that's kind of a fricative tap.
In fact, yes, you're right. It would be, yeah. 333 stříbrných stříkaček stříkalo přes 333 stříbrných střech.
333 stříbrných stříkaček
stříkalo přes 333 stříbrných střech.
333 stříbrných stříkaček stříkalo přes 333 stříbrných střech.
The funny thing is that actually what you have here is only the voiceless variant of the ž. All these instances are preceded by t, so you have tři, tři, whereas if you had something like bříza, the birch tree, bříza, bříza, you would have the voiced variant of the ž, the ž.
Voiced, vocalized type of laugh. For laughter, it's better never than late, unless you want to be interpreted as sarcastic. Thank you.
Federal Express Delivery Service. This was likely due to the fact that the word espresso is now becoming a lexical item in its own right, with only a fading etymological connection to the word express.
Characters who are depicted as potentially dominant or authoritative have these archy varieties. The stags largely depicted as being speakers of regional Yorkshire English.
I'm walking along with what seems like a fairly substantial proportion of the world's population across the Charles Bridge, which passes over the river Vltava. The river's known to a lot of people in the English-speaking world by its German name, the Moldau. That's certainly the most usual English name for the piece written about the river by the great composer Smetana. And And that sequence of VLT at the beginning of a word is a bit intimidating for English speakers. But in fact, this word has three syllables, Vltava. And like practically every word in Czech, this name has stress on the first syllable. And the heart of that syllable is the letter L. Now, English can have syllabic L's as well, like in medieval. But when we get syllabic consonants in English, they're generally always, there's the river, they're generally always in weak syllables. Whereas, as I said before, the L in Vltava is stressed. L isn't the only consonant that you can stress in Czech. The same thing happens to the trill R, as in the name of the city, Brno. So there you go. And that's the Vltava, which I must say is extremely beautiful, as well as being interesting to pronounce.
Okna. S okna.
One of the things I wanted to explore for this study that I'm using as an excuse for some methodological implications.
Ooh, Rachel! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Still not absolutely consistent. I catch myself. And speaking of headlines, here are some of the headlines that I'd like to see perhaps listed on that conversation website at some point in the future.